These are two things, to be called as a pastor and to be called as a Christian. We're talking about it. And I found that there are a lot of challenges to those who are called to be pastors. Because one of the reasons is you must say, God says. God says this. And to extend that, you can go to a point of saying what is not. Always you say, God says, or the Bible says. So I think this is our challenge today. Not nowadays, pastors, but this is our challenge today. And it has been a challenge even before. Where the prophets were prophesying, and still there will be false prophets. I remember Micaiah who prophesied bad things all the time.
And
when prophets were prophesying good things. So we have this challenge of hearing God. But as a Christian, when you come to church, it's easy. You can just sit there, you listen to the pastor, you say, amen. You lift your hands, you dance nicely, you go home. But I told Mama that maybe God must lower us a little. So that, you know, in our pastoring, we don't see money, we don't see progress. Maybe those who are following us, they will know it's not all about money or progress.
Because
people now, they will be trying to be pastors because pastors are rich, prophets are making money, this and that. So, already, unfortunate is, God will never allow that to happen. Because when you are serving God faithfully, you are bound to be blessed. Tell
your
neighbor, when you are serving God faithfully, you are bound to be blessed. You are bound to be blessed. So still, it can still take long for you not to get the blessing, but one day you'll get it. You can also serve God, whether you're a pastor or a Christian, serving God with all your heart, serving big God and remain small. So that's where I was just saying, I wish God didn't do it that way. Maybe we won't have this crisis of not hearing God. But the crisis is there of not hearing God because there are others who have money, blessing, somebody to claim to hear God can just say, I'm hearing God.
So that
you also have money, blessing, whatever. So I want to tell you that we as Christians, whether we are called as pastors or Christians, let's learn to establish our character. A character that suits what Jesus died for. So that even when we suffer, waiting upon Him, we won't be ashamed by the day of visitation. I'm trying to say that it doesn't matter whether things are tough now, but holding on to Jesus, it won't end you to be on the other side of a failure. God is still going to bless you.